Okay, let's do some math for fun here with this integral. And as you can see, this time we put down the square root of x plus 1 plus square root of x in the denominator. Last time, we put this inside of the ln. But anyway, you know, pause the video, try this first. Okay, how did you guys do this? You may want to try to do any kind of substitution. Maybe you can do what we did last time. But let me tell you, think back to your algebra class. What would you do when you have square roots like this in the denominator? You don't need to do anything fancy in this integral, okay? In fact, we can just multiply the top and bottom by its conjugate. So I erase the dx, I have more space. Let's just multiply the bottom by square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x. And of course, do the same thing on the top. You don't need to use any kind of substitution. Of course, let's put on the dx. Because now you'll see this actually simplifies the integral tremendously. We will have the integral, and then on the top is, of course, this times that, so it's just that square root of x plus 1 minus square root of x over what's on the bottom? Well, when you multiply this out, you know you just square the first term, which you get x plus 1, and then you subtract the second term square, which is x, right? And of course, this and that cancel, you just have a nice 1 in the denominator. So I guess sometimes it's useful when you're doing integrations to rationalize the denominator, right? So, okay. Well, let's get this put on the power form to get ready. This is the integral, and this is like saying x plus 1 raised to the 1 half power, and then minus, this is of course x to the 1 half power, and dx. And some people might want you to put down a big parenthesis like this. Doesn't really matter in my opinion. But anyway, we'll finish this. We add 1 to the exponent, which becomes 3 half, and then divided by 3 half, which is the same as multiplied by 2 thirds. Likewise, do the same right here. 3 half, and then 2 thirds. So in the end, of course, you can leave the answer in the power form or radical form, up to you. But we will have 2 thirds. And usually, if the question starts off with a radical form, I would like to end up with my answer with radical form as well. So this becomes a square root, and then the x plus 1. And for the third power, you can put this down on the outside, or you can put the third power like this inside. Right, and let's finish this right here, minus 2 thirds, and same thing, we get the square root of x to the third power. And we are done, so we can be happy, and let's put down plus c. And with that, that's it.